I believe we have a choice in this world about how to tell sad stories. On the one hand, you can sugarcoat it. Well, nothing is too messed up that can't be fixed with a Peter Gabriel song. I like that version as much as the next girl does. It's just not the truth. This is the truth. Doctor's appointments, reality shows, worst of all, support groups.
Christ is our friend and he'll be there till the end.
All right. Hazel? How are you doing?
You mean besides the cancer? All right, I guess.
Why don't I play another song?
You need to be a teenager.
If you want me to be a teenager, you don't send me to support group. You gotta give me a fake ID so that I can go to clubs and take pot.
You don't take pot?
That is the kind of thing I would know with a fake ID.
Hey, make some friends.
Sorry.
My bad.
I'm Augustus Waters. I've been in remission for about a year and a half.
Maybe you'd like to share some of your fears with the group.
Oblivion. What's your name?
Hazel. Why are you staring at me?
Because you're beautiful.
Really? You just ruined this whole thing.
The whole thing?
Yes, this whole thing.
Oh, man.
You're doing really well, too.
I never lit one.
Hmm?
It's a metaphor, see? You put the thing that does the killing right between your teeth, but you never give it the power to kill you. A metaphor. So, what's your story?
I was diagnosed when I was 13.
No, not your cancer story.
Your real story.
Your hobbies, your passions, your weird fetishes.
I am quite unextraordinary.
I reject that at the hand.
You know, Gus talks about you all the time.
We're just friends.
You trying to keep your distance from me in no way lessens my affection for you.
Gus, I'm a grenade. One day I'm gonna blow up, and I'm gonna obliterate everything in my wake, and I don't wanna hurt you.
You don't get to choose if you get hurt in this world, but you do have a say in who hurts you.
I am in love with you, Hazel Grace.
I guess.
And I know that love is just a shout into the void and that oblivion is inevitable. And I am in love with you. All your efforts to keep me from you are gonna fail. If that's what you want.
So angry.
You need to break something.
I fell in love with him the way you fall asleep. Slowly, and then all at once.
It's a good life, Hazel Grace. Okay?
Okay.
Does it say in the book that they have the exact same haircut? Because it's super distracting. It seems like a very odd choice. From the creative team of the film to give Shailene Woodley and Ansel Elgort the exact same haircut. It's just a little bit off-putting, but I have to say this trailer is so good, that's the only problem that I can find with it. I think this is a much more compelling trailer than the first one. I think this does a fantastic job of capturing kind of the truthfulness of the film, that it's a very honest movie, which I really appreciate. I'm someone who also personally believes you should be honest with yourself, even about the bad things, so I like seeing that in a film. But it looks like it has some of the fun, mushy stuff that she's kind of putting off at the beginning of the trailer, at least, with the Peter Gabriel song line, but it looks like she finds her own Peter Gabriel moments anyway. I guess that's what this character, this Ansel Elgort character, introduces into her life. And they, very good acting duo here, and their chemistry together is quite good. Like that cigarette line should have been super cheesy, but that whole pickup scene, they really pull off. I think she handles her lines really well. He's great delivering that little metaphor, which about halfway through, or the second time, I guess, I watched this trailer twice before reviewing it. I was like, wait a minute, does he do this with all the cancer chicks? Because he's just so smooth at it. But it works really well. And there's a naturalness to their rapport. Maybe it's because they worked on other films together. Of course, they were both in Divergent. And speaking of Divergent, I'm not quite sure if this is actually a better trailer, as I just said, or the more I've been thinking about it, perhaps I'm just more of a Shailene Woodley fan after seeing Divergent. If you might recall from my review of that film, I really enjoyed the film and I really enjoyed her performance, where she was also, I felt, very natural. So the unexpected benefit, while the box office hasn't been huge for that movie, it might have won her over quite a few fans. And of course, She did very well at the MTV Movie Awards with Triss, that character. So you can see that I think Shailene Woodley's star is rising, not as fast as Jennifer Lawrence's, but I think she's definitely on Lawrence's tail. And I like that, you know, they have some similarities, but I think that while Jennifer Lawrence is loud and proud, I guess you could say, I think that Shailene Woodley has a quiet strength, which I think is also nice to see. So I think this is a great trailer. It looks very good without giving away too much of the movie. Now, like an idiot, I went and looked up the end of this book because everyone was talking about how great this book was when the first trailer came out. So I was like, I don't really mind spoilers and it won't affect me when I watch this movie. But if somebody else knows what happens, I like to know what happens. So I went and looked it up. So it's my own fault because I sought out the spoiler. So I know what's coming, and I think this trailer does a very good job of not giving it away. So I'm actually excited about this film, and I think, for instance, there's another movie that has very similar themes, If I Stay. I'll put my link to that trailer review at the end here. But two very strong actresses, Chloe Grace Moretz. I think Chloe Grace Moretz still has a few stumbling blocks in terms of connecting with the audience, as I talk about in that trailer review. And between the two of these films, which seem very similar in the same wheelhouse, I'd have to say that I think The Fault in Our Stars looks like a better film so far. It'll be interesting to see if the marketplace can handle two such films, which are very similar. But I like this one a lot, and I liked Ansel Elgort since Carrie, the Carrie remake. Speaking of Chloe Grace Moretz, he was quite good there as well. So this trailer, phenomenal. It looks great. I'm curious to what you guys think. A lot of you asked me to review it. It made quite a bit of a splash yesterday when Yahoo debuted it. I have to wait for it to become available to be uploaded onto YouTube because it's a Yahoo exclusive for a little bit of time, usually about 24 hours. But this is a good trailer and I'm very excited about it. So leave your own thoughts down below. Thank you so much for watching my review, and you can check out some more episodes right now.